Dear students, we will be learning about various aspects of family structure and composition. Let us now look at basics of family structure. Family is a complex and dynamic institution in India. For many decades, several studies were carried out to understand this complexity. In India, people learn the essential themes of cultural life within the bosom of a family. In most of the country, the basic units of society are the patrilineal family unit and wider kinship groupings. The most widely desired residential unit is the joint family, ideally consisting of three or four patrilineally related generations, all living under one roof, working, eating, worshipping and cooperating together in mutually beneficial social and economic activities. The family forms the basic unit of social organization, and it is difficult to imagine how human society could function without it. The family has been seen as a universal institution, an inevitable part of human society. According to Burgess and Locke, the family is a group of persons united by ties of marriage, blood or adoption, constituting a single household, interacting with each other in their respective social role of husband and wife, mother and father, brother and sister, creating a common culture. G.P. Murdoch defines the family as a social group characterized by common residence. It includes adults of both sexes, at least two of whom maintain a socially approved sexual relationship, and one or more children, owned or adopted, of the sexually cohabiting adults. Nimkov says that family is a more or less durable association of husband and wife with or without child, or of a man or woman alone with children. According to McLever, family is a group defined by sex relationships sufficiently precise and enduring to provide for the procreation and upbringing of children. Kingsley Davis describes family as a group of persons whose relations to one another are based upon consanguinity and who are therefore kin to one another. Malinowski explained that the family is an institution within which the cultural traditions of a society is handed over to a newer generation. This indispensable function could not be filled unless the relations to parents and children were relations reciprocally of authority and respect. According to Talcott Parsons, families are factories which produce human personalities. Origin of the family. Having known the basics of generic family structure, we will now see origin of family. The origin of the family, like that of a marriage, is a matter of surmise. It cannot be discussed with historical precision. Its origin cannot be attributed to any particular period. It has grown over the time. Family is a universal concept. The sexual urge of men and women, the desire of men to bear a child, of men to perpetuate his line, and of both to look after their procreation, coupled with the desire of economic security for leisure and for pleasure on the basis of division of labor, may have contributed to the origin of the family. Sexual urge, the consequent affinity, and socio-economic expediency appear to be the basis of this institution. McLever has given several characteristics of a family. The mating relations is the significant. It is only with this relation that a family comes into being. But this relationship is made possible by the institution of marriage. The married ones live together at a place to procreate. They arrange for their own economic fulfillment and of their young ones. Once the family is thus constituted, it adopts a system of nomenclature according to their descent and residence. It is difficult to determine if family originated from marriage or marriage originated from family. The term grahastha and parim have connotations not much different from imilia and familus. The family system existed even before Vedic age, as indicated by the finds at Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. Its ancient origin is further evidenced by the stray references to it in the ancient Tamil language. We do not, however, have a workable knowledge about the origin of this social institution. In the Vedic literature, the sacredness of marriage tie has been repeatedly emphasized. The family ideal of the Vedic people was very high. The Vedic invocation in this connection is highly meaningful. Be thou mother of heroic children devoted to the gods. Be thou queen in the father-in-law's household. May all the gods unite the hearts of us two into one. Ours is an extended family system. In it, wife, husband, parents of the husband, husband's brothers and sisters, and also other blood relations on husband's side live under the same roof. The management of this joint family is in the hands of the head of the family, who is the eldest living male. The members of the family have equal rights in the income and in the property of the family, whatever the contribution of individual members to the family offer may be. The fulfillment of the four purushastas, kama, artha, dharma and moksha, have been described as the aim of life, and in this it has been emphasized is possible only through family life. The aim of procreation has been emphasized to the birth of a son. It has been described very essential both from worldly and religious points of view. The concepts of rinas, death, is also based on the procreation of a son. Of all the rinas, fulfillment of the parental rina is the highest. No man could perform religious rites without being married. Marriage is thus most important of the sanskaras. The enjoyment of sex has been given the importance as it has been given to the fulfillment of dharma. Structure of family. We now know how the family system originated. Now, you look at the structure of the family. The basic structure of the family is provided by the individual nuclear family, the incest taboos, the form of marriage, and the rules of residence. Individual nuclear family is of course of significant importance. As Loewy writes, it does not matter whether marital relations are permanent or temporary, whether there is polygamy or sexual license, whether conditions are complicated by the addition of members not included in our family circle. The one fact stands out beyond all others, that everywhere husband, wife and immature children constitute a unit apart from the remainder of the community. It is nuclear as it is combined with others to form more complex families. In combining with other families, the competent nuclear families always retain their separate identity. The basic structure of the family depends on the incest taboos. It follows that the nuclear family is linked to two generations. Murdoch thus points out that, in consequence, every normal adult in every human society belongs to at least two nuclear families, a family of orientation in which he was born and reared, and which includes his father, mother, brothers and sisters, and a family of orientation which establishes by his marriage and which includes his wife or husband, his sons and daughters. The two families are similar in structure, but for the fact that in one a particular person has the position of a son or daughter and in the other the husband or wife. A third generation can only result from the formation of new families between the existing nuclear families. Indian family structure is believed to be the unit that teaches the values and worth of an honest living that have been carried down across generations. Since the Puranic ages, Indian family structure was that of a joint family, indicating every person of the same clan living together. However, this idea of elaborate living disintegrated in smaller family units. With the passing time, nuclear families have evolved, that is a couple living with their unmarried children. There are often strong networks of kinship ties through which economic assistance and other benefits are obtained. Often, clusters of relatives live near each other who are easily available and respond to give and take of kinship obligations. Even when relatives cannot actually live in close proximity, they typically maintain strong bonds of kinship and attempt to provide each other with economic help, emotional support, and other required benefits. The Indian joint families grew even larger and finally they divide into smaller units, passing through an expected cycle over time. The breakup of a joint family into smaller units does not necessarily symbolize the rejection of the joint family ideally. Rather, it is usually a reaction to a variety of conditions, including the requirement for some members to move from village to city or from one city to another to obtain the advantage of employment opportunities. Types of family structure. We all understood the structure of the family in general, but there are different types in it. Let us look at them now. Family structure is not the same everywhere. It differs from society to society. Kingsley Davis has listed some major variables that are available in the family structure. There are, among others, the marital relations, the number of spouses, authority, strength of bond, choice of spouse, residence, etc., the parent-child relation, and sibling relations. There exists a broad distinction between family systems in which the nuclear family is relatively independent and systems in which it is incorporated into a larger group, the polygamous or the extended family. The independent nuclear family is characteristics of modern industrial societies. Its predominance seems to be due to the growth of individual happiness, self-fulfillment, and geographical and social mobility. It has also been affected by the increasing state provision for individual misfortune. The individual is no longer so dependent upon his family in times of distress. This marked predominance of the relatively autonomous nuclear family is a sacred phenomenon and it has appeared most fully in the most advanced industrial societies, particularly USA. The solidarity of this type of family depends largely upon sexual attraction and companionship between husband and wife, companionship between parents and children. This does not seem to be such a basis as the wider complex of rights and obligations which exist in the extended family. The loss of economic functions is more important than most sociologists have recognized. Divorce is frequent and has been increasing in most of the Western countries. The solidarity of the independent nuclear family is greater where it includes young children, but as the children grow up, the bonds tend to weaken again through the influence of peer groups and later as a result of social mobility and geographical mobility. The composite or the incorporated family is of ancient origin and long tradition. In Western industrial society, it has long ceased to exist. It continued to exist in Yugoslavia until the beginning of present century. In our country, the joint family has existed since the earliest times as indicated above. It was a corporate body. Their concerns, agriculture or commerce, was common. Their property was held in common. It was quite usual for families to comprise three or four generations to live under the same shelter and to eat from common kitchen. Besides the property and work, joint worship and ritual was an important force that kept the joint family united. Numerous prominent Indian families such as the Tatas, Birlas and Sarabhais retain joint family arrangements even today, and they work together to control some of the country's largest financial empires. In China too, a system similar to our family system existed. The ideal of family in China was the patrimonial extended family. In each generation, the men brought their wives to their father's house, and the strongest social tie in China, at least in theory, was between father and son. The oldest man was the head of the joint household. He was succeeded by his eldest son. Classification of families. Having learnt about different types in structure of families, let us see classification of families. There can be, as we have seen above, various variations in the structure of family. These have been generalized under two categories: nuclear family and composite family. Family can also be classified as patriarchal and matriarchal. In a patriarchal family, women after marriage lives with her husband. Father holds the supreme authority on children and chattae. This descent in this type of family is traced from father's side. The property is inherited only by the male descendants. In patriarchal family, living male presides over religious rites and performs all the connected functions. Vedic family was of patriarchal type. Authority of the father, that is of the living male ancestor, was supreme. This remains the character of our family even now. In the matriarchal family, husband does not necessarily live with the wife. Children are brought up in the home of the wife's relative. The authority totally remains vested in the hands of the wife or in representative of the wife's relation. Dependence is traced through the mother and property is inherited only by the females. On the basis of marriage, family has been classified into three major types: polygynous family, polyandrous family, monogamous family. On the basis of nature of residence, family can be classified into three main forms: family of matrilocal residence, family of patrilocal residence, family of changing residence. On the basis of ancestry or descent, family can be classified into two main types: matrilineal family, patrilineal family. On the basis of size or structure and the depth of generations, family can be classified into two main types: nuclear or the single unit family, joint family. On the basis of nature of relations among the family members, the family can be classified into two main types. The conjugal family, which consists of adult members among their exact sex relationship. Consanguine family, which consists of members among whom there exists blood relationship, brother and sister, father and son, etc. Function of family. Are you aware of the functions of a family? No, we will see them now. The aim of marriage is to have hybrid progeny according to Rig Veda. Its main purpose, according to Vatsyayan, is the satisfaction of sex needs. While sex fulfillment is essential, marriage is not a license to live as spouses. Being the basis of social structure involves individual, mutual, and social obligations. The aim of marriage has therefore been described as fulfillment of kama, artha, dharma, and moksha. The concept of rina further elaborates the aims, obligations, and functions of family. The parental rinas are cleared by procreation of a son and by bringing him up as an educated man. Of saints and teachers are cleared by study and by educating one's children, and of the gods by performing the required sanskaras. Kingsley Davis has distinguished four major social functions of a family. These are reproduction, maintenance, placement, and socialization. McLever divides the functions of the family into two categories, essential and non-essential. Under the essential, he includes three functions: stable satisfaction of sex need, 2. Production and rearing of children, and 3. Provision of a home. Under the non-essential functions, he mentions religious, educational, economic, health, and recreation. These, he says, have now been transferred to specialized agencies in society. Lundberg has enumerated 4 basic functions of a family. 1. The regulations of sexual behavior and reproduction. 2. Care and training of children. 3. Cooperation and division of labor. 4. Primary group satisfactions. All sociologists accept reproduction, maintenance, socialization, and placement being the essential functions of family. Reproduction. All are agreed to it that reproduction is the primary aim of family marriage, is the social sanction of sexual union leading to procreation. The act of reproduction includes to look after the children and to bring them up well. The Rina theory recognizes these functions fully. Marriage is also means to regulate the sex relations. Sex morality is generally regarded essential for good marital relations. These are societies, however, which permit premarital and extramarital relations. In the Western countries, where the nuclear family is the accepted pattern, most of these functions are now performed by the state.